chugga chugga, chugga chugga, chugga chugga, chugga chugga. All aboard the choo choo train, all aboard the choo choo train, all aboard the choo choo train.
All aboard!
Hi, I'm Mira
and I'm Arisa.
Welcome to our choo choo train. Today our destination is
Well, as we know, there are two poles in every type of magnet, the north and the south. Opposite poles attract, identical poles repel. So levitation occurs when the repulsive force created by electromagnetic fields that are created when electricity is passed through a conductor equalizes the weight of the train. Basically, the electromagnetic force from the identical poles are stopping gravitational force, which then causes levitation.
Whoa, but the train can still topple over due to instability, right?
That's why, to create proper and consistent levitation, superconductors are used to help with this problem. Plus, a little support from pseudo-levitation, which is a system that provides stability to levitated objects by a magnetic mechanism.
Whoa, that's so cool!
The power from the electromagnetic fields also causes the train to push and pull, which then eliminates friction, therefore causing the trains to travel more than 500 km per hour, right?
Yes!
Arisa, how can a bullet train move very, very fast? They go shoo!
To achieve the speed of more than 500 kilometers per hour, maglev trains need to be as aerodynamic as possible in order to cause little wind resistance, which is why the front part of bullet trains are tapered like the nose of an airplane. Basically, the streamlined shape of a high-speed bullet train helps decrease air resistance, allowing the train to travel more efficiently. The more it resists the wind, the quicker the train travels.
Here I have a aerodynamic shape, and I have the rectangular block. So, let's push this together and see who's gonna go at the end faster. One, two, three.
The sand in the cardboard represents air resistant. So as you can see, the model which has an aerodynamic shape is easier to pull compared to the non-aerodynamic shape model. This clearly shows that when the shape is aerodynamic, it can resist the wind.
Mira,
yes?
These bullet trains move like very, very fast. Why don't they provide us seatbelts? I mean, isn't that dangerous?
Well, Miss Arisa, actually, wearing seatbelts in a bullet train is more dangerous than not. working.
How come? They tell us to wear seatbelts in cars all the time.
Cause, Miss Arisa, it's like that!
I need a scientific explanation.
Okay, chill, Miss Arisa, let me show you.
So here, we have a high gradient ramp to create high acceleration and low gradient ramp to create low acceleration.
So you're saying that the car on the higher gradient ramp represents a moving bullet train?
Yes.
While the car on the lower gradient ramp represents a moving car?
Yes.
True.
In each toy car, there will be a model of the person made out of plasticine and the seat belt is made out of a cable tie.
Here I have the higher slope and I have the lower slope. So I'm gonna go first and see what will happen to the plasticine. Now it's time for my dummy. Saving sound.
The first model jerks on the less steep slope. The model is seen to be unscathed, whereas the second model that jerks on the steeper slope suffered a deep dent on the area where the seatbelt is.
You're saying that if I wear a seatbelt on a bullet train, I can break my bones and eventually die?
Yes, Arisa, yes.
Oh no.
Inertia causes the model to continue to move forward at the same speed even when the brake has been applied. This causes the model to be thrown forward with a very high momentum due to the high speed of the train. This causes the model to be thrown forward with a very high momentum due to the high speed of the train.
Oh, is that so?
Yes!
The change in momentum within a short period of time causes the impulse force to be higher and this can cause fatality to the passengers.
Okay, Arisa, now I want you to read this out loud.
Change of momentum over time. Mira, what does this equation have anything to do with our demonstration?
From the equation, time is inversely proportional to the impulsive force. This means the shorter the time impact, the greater the impulsive force.
Ah, see, now I know why bullet trains don't have any seatbelts. Because seatbelts can cause a greater impact to a human if the bullet train were to stop abruptly.
Yes!
So seatbelts can crush human bones?
Indeed.
Wow.
Arisa, isn't it cool that the fact that seatbelts are dangerous in bullet trains?
Oh my god, yes! You can move freely anywhere, anytime when you're in a bullet train.
Yes.
Cool.
Do you know that the train's chairs are rotatable?
I did not know that.
Why it is built like that is so that you will face forward whenever you're traveling.
That's so cool. Tell me more about it.
Why it is built is because so that you will experience less motion sickness or none at all. Arisa, could you explain what is motion sickness?
Of course!
Motion sickness is a common problem faced by people traveling by car, train, airplanes, and boats. But how is it possible? Well, when we are traveling, our eyes can foresee our destination and can predict the motion of the train. If we can predict when the train will stop, it immediately sends information to our brain. What will happen if we're facing backwards? When we are facing backward, our eyes cannot predict. Any abrupt stop will disrupt the system in our brain.
Do you know that our ear has another function besides hearing?
Yes, in its innermost part, there are a group of structures called the vestibular system, which gives us a sense of movement and balance.
Inside, there are three semicircular tubules that can sense rotation and one for each dimension of space. True! There are also two hairline sacs filled with fluid, so when you move, the fluid shifts and tickles the hairs, telling your brain if you are moving vertically or horizontally. All this tells your body which direction you are moving in, how much you have accelerated, or even at what angle. So, when you are in a train, your vestibular system correctly senses your movement, but your eyes don't see it, especially when you're reading a book. Here's a model that we have invented to explain this.
This is a container filled with water. The water represents fluid, also known as endolymph, that fills the hairline sacs in our ear.
Let me show you how this works. Let's put this on a stool and give it a spin. As you can see, the liquid is now spinning too, but when we stop the stool from spinning, the liquid does not stop. Meaning, as we move, the endolymph moves as well, so when we stop abruptly without alerting our brain, the endolymph continues to move due to inertia.
So if you didn't know what inertia is, it's basically the tendency of an object to remain at rest or move at a constant speed unless there is an external force acting upon it. Yes, for example, if a bus were to stop suddenly, its passengers will fall forward due to the inertia of motion.
That's good! Yeah.
Magnetic levitation. Bullet trains do not have wheels but can move by a technology known as magnetic levitation. So, levitation occurs when the repulsive force created by electromagnetic fields that are created when electricity is passed through a conductor equalizes the weight of a train. Basically, the electromagnetic force from the identical poles are stopping gravitational force, which then causes levitation. Streamline shape. The front part of bullet trains are tapered like the nose of an airplane, which is known as a streamline shape. The streamline shape of a high-speed bullet train helps decrease air resistance, allowing the train to travel more efficiently. Meaning, the more it resists the wind, the quicker the train travels. Momentum. A car which has lower impact than bullet trains is safer for the passengers to wear seatbelts. A bullet train has higher impact compared to a car, which is not safe for the passengers to wear seatbelts as it can cause more harm to them. Motion sickness. Motion sickness is caused by the two different messages sent by the ears and eyes to the brain. When in a moving bullet train, our eyes tell our brain that we are not moving, but our ears tell our brain that we are accelerating, as our ears can sense movement and balance besides hearing.
Chugga, 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 chugga.